This is an overview of the programming language Cell. Cell is intended for front-end applications, GUIs, games, and interactive applications in general. We target from desktops to very constrained embedded systems with very little memory. Here are some examples. Usually, these applications are ruled by an external component, the environment. The environment issues events to the application, which has to respond with immediate feedback, in real time. Cell is all about logical reasoning and deterministic behavior for concurrency inside these applications. Let's start with a simple example, blinking a LED on and off every 500 milliseconds. In Cell, we can write an infinite loop that awaits that period and then changes the state of the LED, staying forever in this loop. Then, suppose we want to start blinking after a button press. After blinking for a while, we press the button and the blinking stops. To implement this, we can enclose the blinking behavior with a parallel composition that also waits for the button press in another line of execution. Here, we are using a parallel OR. So, when either of the two trails terminate, the other is automatically aborted and the whole composition rejoins, proceeding to the next line. Then, suppose we want to restart after 2 seconds. So, after blinking for a while, we press the button to stop, and after 2 seconds everything restarts. Now, after the parallel composition rejoins, we can wait 2 seconds in sequence and enclose everything with another loop to restart. In Cell, we use a lot this idea of compositions, with sequences, loops, and parallels. The goal is to avoid the use of state variables and explicit communication between trails for control purposes. With Cell, we want to go from structured programming to structured reactive programming. In structured programming, we use control mechanisms. We rely on blocks to define scopes in which we can define local variables with lexical memory management. Then, we abstract these ideas in subroutines. However, structured programming was not conceived with reactivity in mind. Now, we have the environment in control of the application. This way, when the environment issues an event, the application can only execute a short-lived callback. The callback has to return the control to the environment as soon as possible to process new events and keep the application responsive. This way, we can no longer have lasting loops and our scopes are also short-lived inside these callbacks. This proceeding essentially breaks structured programming. Structured reactive programming extends structured programming with new functionality. An await statement that suspends the line of execution, keeping all contexts alive, parallels for multiple lines of execution, and an underlying synchronous execution module that defines time as a sequence of reactions to events, bringing deterministic behavior for concurrency. This is not a new idea, but here we want to propose abstraction mechanisms for structured reactive programming. We now want two independent blinking LEDs. We change the original example to blink a specific LED and awake from a specific button. Then, we copy and paste the code and change the parameters for the LED and the button. Finally, we enclose the two behaviors with a parallel composition to make them concurrent. With procedural abstractions, we can do better than that. Cell provides a code-await abstraction mechanism that supports all control statements of the language, including parallel compositions. Here, we define a LED procedure that receives as arguments the LED to blink and the button to react. In this case, the procedure executes forever and never returns. A code-await body reacts directly to the environment and does not depend on explicit listeners, observers, or other standard techniques. The whole behavior is self-contained on the abstraction. Now, we use the LED abstraction to replace the copy and paste with two invocations of the procedure in parallel. If we need 6 independent blinking LEDs, we just need to put them all in parallel. Cold-await abstractions are subject to lexical scope, just like local variables. In this example, we use a parallel OR with all independent blinking LEDs and another trail that terminates when a specific button is pressed. When I press the button, the first trail terminates, the par OR rejoins, and all LED invocations go out of scope. All memory is reclaimed and all bodies are aborted because the invocations go out of scope. They only restart because we enclose everything with a loop. We now have an abstraction mechanism, but the examples are still static. Let's change the example. We now want flap bird animations. We start with only two birds in parallel. We hide the implementation to illustrate that only the interface matters, and the reactions to the environment are abstracted inside the body. Like we did with the blinking LEDs, we can use a par OR to abort the animations on a mouse click and enclose everything with a loop to restart. If we want more birds, we can also use the spawn primitive, which instead of waiting, starts the procedure to execute in the background. Here, we spawn 5 birds. We should also specify where these birds will reside in memory. A pool is a container for cold await instances. Since the spawn doesn't block, the loop will terminate and will reach the wait forever statement that will keep the application alive. We now create a new bird with random position and speed every second. Again, we use the spawn primitive and a pool to hold the instances. The pool that we specified holds a maximum of 5 birds. We can see in the demo that after the 5th bird, new allocations will fail. The animations will continue to execute even after they leave the screen. Alternatively, we can specify an unbounded loop, and now the application is fully dynamic. Let's look inside the bird implementation. We have an animation trail which awakes on every update event to increment the bird position, and a drawing trail which awakes on every draw input. Both trails execute forever and the abstraction never terminates. Let's modify the animation so that it terminates when reaching a limit on the screen. The redrawing trail remains unchanged and the par composition as a whole never terminates. Now all birds accumulate at the end of the screen. If we move back to the bounded pool, it is now clear why new allocations fail. The procedures are still active redrawing the birds. However, if we modify the par composition to a par OR, the termination of the animation trail will cause the abortion of the redrawing trail and the natural termination of the whole procedure. Visually, the birds disappear when they reach the end of the screen. Note that spawned procedures are anonymous. There are no identifiers or references to them. Hence, if we do not have a reference to a procedure and that procedure can no longer react to the environment on termination, there is no reason to keep it in memory. Cold await abstractions are automatically reclaimed from memory on termination, not demanding a free primitive in the language. We can see that the pool of 5 birds is continually recycled bird after bird. Here, we enclose the previous example with a parallel OR that terminates with a mouse click and we enclose the composition with an outer loop. Now, when we click the mouse, all birds disappear and the example restarts. Apu also has lexical scope, and when it terminates, all of its active procedures are automatically aborted. We can now reason about the lifetime of dynamic instances just observing the source code, in a similar way as we do with local variables in structured programming. Here, we simplify the previous example with the watching construct, which is equivalent to a par or aborted by a single event. In this example, we want to detect collisions between birds and make them disappear. In addition to spawning the birds, every frame we iterate over the active birds 2x2. A pool iterator provides access to a public interface of the code await abstraction. In this case, the bird position and dimension, and an internal event to signal collisions. This way, we can check for collisions and notify both instances if it is the case. Looking at the new implementation for the birds, the public interface is exposed and initialized at the beginning of the abstraction. Now, the body also terminates when a collision occurs. As a new functionality, let's make the birds fall when colliding. After the collision, but before terminating, we animate the bird down until it reaches the floor. To complete the animation, after reaching the floor, we make the birds blink during 1 second before disappearing. We add a hide event, and during 1 second, we toggle the event state every 100 milliseconds. The pause if composition makes the redrawing trail to pause whenever the event is set to true. Going back to the main application with the pool of birds, periodic spawns, and collision detection, we now enclose it with a pause if which pauses all animations when the user presses P. We declare a freeze event and emit true on a P press. While in the paused state, we keep redrawing an image until P is pressed again. The par or rejoins and we resume the animations until the next pause. In the last modification, we want to track the position of a clicked bird by drawing a line from its center to the bottom of the screen. We first wait for a mouse click and iterate over the birds to see if any was clicked. If this is the case, we assign to an option alias and keep redrawing the line while the reference is alive. In summary, Cell supports structured mechanisms to deal with events. Cell extends traditional structured programming with an await statement, parallel compositions, and seamless abortion of code. It also provides a form of abstraction that is subject to lexical scope. Thanks.